Are you looking for a way to make your photos stand out on Instagram and TikTok? In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create an amazing effect to animate your photographs on your social media platforms. Once inside DaVinci Resolve with the photograph you want to animate, you'll need to create different masks to separate each element and animate them individually. Create a mask for the person, another for the car, one more that includes the ground and the wall, and a final one for the background. Next, copy and paste your photograph as many times as there are elements you want to select. In my case, I need to select 4 different parts of the photograph. However, to duplicate elements more quickly, I recommend this little trick. Hold down the Alt key, select the clip, and drag it to another spot on the timeline. This way, you can duplicate any clip without having to copy and paste it. Great, we now have 4 clips of the photograph we need. In the first clip, we'll make a mask of the person. To create masks in DaVinci Resolve, there are 2 different methods, one for the studio version and another for the free version. First, I'll show you how to do it in the paid version and then how to do it for free. All right, the first step is to place the playhead over the clip we're going to use and go to the Fusion module. Once in Fusion, right-click on the Media in One node, which is the node that contains the image. Press the keyboard shortcut Shift-Space to open the Tool Selector and look for the tool Magic Mask, which will allow us to automatically select the person. Click on Add. As we're going to create a mask on a photograph instead of a video, we need to add another effect. Select the Magic Mask node. Reopen the Tool Finder by pressing Shift-Space, and look for the effect Time Stretcher. Add the effect. Since we're creating the mask on a photograph where there is obviously no movement, it's not possible to perform motion tracking. That's why we added the Time Stretcher effect. It will help us keep the mask active in all frames. Creating the mask is super simple. Select the Magic Mask 1 node and position yourself on the first frame, frame 0. Now, simply place the cursor over the element you want to select with the magic mask and click the left mouse button. Hold it down and draw this blue line over the entire person. Just like that, we've separated the person from the rest of the image. Lastly, it's advisable to switch from faster mode to better mode for a more precise mask selection. I have selected only the person, but I also need to include the handbag they were holding. To make it easier to add parts to the mask, we will enable dual viewing. One viewer to see our mask and the other to view the original image. Click on this small left circle of the Media in One node to view the original image in the left viewer. Perfect. Now we have a reference to be able to select the handbag or any other element we want to add. Left-click in the viewer and select the handbag with the chains. A car wheel has appeared, but don't worry. To remove it, just switch the stroke mode to subtract. Then, select the wheel with this red line to remove it from the mask. It's that simple. You can keep adding or subtracting parts to refine the mask. The more precise the selection, the better the final effect will be. Now, if we return to the editing module, we can verify that we indeed have a mask of just the person throughout all the frames of the clip. Position the playhead over the second clip, and this time we will quickly make a mask of the car behind the person. We go to the Fusion module and add the Magic Mask and Time Stretcher nodes, exactly as we did in the previous example. Position ourselves at frame 0, then we will create a mask by selecting all parts of the car. Activate the Media in One node in the left viewer to have the original image as a reference. All right, making sure we have the Magic Mask node selected, left-click over the viewer, ensuring we correctly select the entire car. Switch the mode to Better. And to fix any errors that may have arisen, select the mode Subtract and remove the parts of the background that were selected along with the car. If we return to the editing module, we now have our second mask of the car completed, alongside the mask of the person. Gradually, we are separating the different elements of the photograph. Great! We've learned how to make masks in the paid version of DaVinci Resolve using Magic Mask. As you've seen, it's not too complicated. Next, we'll create a mask using the manual method of DaVinci Resolve, that is, the free method. Let's see how it's done. Place the playhead over the third clip to make the new mask, which should include the entire part of the wall and the floor. This time, we will head to the color module of DaVinci Resolve. Then, we go to the window menu. In this menu, we have different types of masks, but we're interested in the mask with the pen icon, which allows us to customize the shape of the mask. Select the mask, and then left-click to select the entire wall and floor. Don't worry if you also include the person and the car. The important thing is to select the wall and the floor correctly. To create the mask, simply connect the last point with the first one we created. It's that easy. And now we have our third mask created. If you click on the highlight icon, you can better see the mask selection. Check everything carefully, and if there's any mistake, adjust and modify the shape of the mask. Now, to remove the part of the background where the building appears, that is, the part outside the mask, we need to right-click on the node panel and add an alpha output. The alpha output is this blue circle. Simply connect this blue square of the node where we made the mask to the alpha output. And that's it. We have eliminated the part we don't want. I'm going to adjust the selection of the wall a bit, as I've included a small part of the background. Perfect. Finally, if we deactivate the overlay and zoom in a bit on the viewer, we can see that the mask edges are jagged. To correct this, we just need to apply a bit of blur to the edges of the mask. Increase the softness value a bit. Setting it between 0.1 and 0.15 should be sufficient. And as you can see, the edges now look much better. Done! We have finished if we return to the editing module. We have the mask of the person, the mask of the car, and one that contains the wall along with the floor. In the last clip, it's not necessary to create a mask by selecting the building, as the other masks will be on top and cover the entire lower area. Having the original image is sufficient. Great, let's start creating the animation of the image. The first step is to organize and place the clips in the order of appearance. The first thing to appear will be the person, so we will place the person's clip first and on top of all the others. Next, we will place the clip with the car underneath and a few frames to the right. Then, we will add the clip with the wall and the floor. Lastly, the clip with the original image, which we will use as a background. Perfect. This would be the initial organization. When applying the animations, we will better adjust the timings. Now if we play it, all the elements of the photograph will appear one after another until it's complete. It's time to apply the animations. For the animations of this effect, it's advisable to follow the rhythm of the song you're going to use. So let's listen to the music, and then we will adapt our effect according to the beat of the song. To get the best result, we will make each element of the photograph appear exactly on the beats of the song. If we look at the audio waves, we can clearly identify these moments, right when the wave suddenly rises. To be clear on where we will add the clips with the different masks, we will add markers indicating the moments in the song where we should place them. Perfect. With this help, you will see it better. Now, simply place the clips on top of the markers we just added. First clip with the person on top of the first marker, second clip with the car mask on the second marker, and we do the same with the third and fourth clip. We have it now. If we play the video, we will see that the elements appear in rhythm with the song. Make sure to do this well, as it is an important part of the effect. All right. It's time to animate each element. This depends on personal taste. You can make it appear with a zoom, sliding in from the sides, or from above or below. In this example, I will show you how to create a simple zoom animation and another moving from bottom to top. Let's see how it's done. We'll start with the zoom animation and apply it to the first mask of the person. For this, we will create a compound clip from the first clip and then cut a small piece from the beginning of the clip to be able to apply the zoom animation. Perfect. We deactivate the blade tool and make sure the first clip is selected to apply the zoom. Although we could animate it manually by creating keyframes, I recommend using dynamic zoom as it is simpler and faster. Activate dynamic zoom by left-clicking on this circle. And to make the zoom animation smoother, change the mode to ease in, ease out, or ease in and out. This way, the mask of the person will be animated with a zoom in. If you want to modify the zoom speed, simply lengthen or shorten the duration of the first clip, and the zoom will adapt to its duration. Perfect. Now we will animate the background part with the building, making it appear from bottom to top. This time, we will apply a transition at the beginning of the clip. Go to the Effects panel, and in the Video Transitions section, look for the Push transition. Select the transition and drag it to the beginning of the clip that contains the background of the building. Perfect. Once we apply the transition, click on it to open the Settings menu. Now in the Inspector menu, we can configure the transition. In my case, I want the building to move from bottom to top. So I will change the preset setting to push up. As we can see, now the building will appear from bottom to top. To make the animation look smoother and less noticeable that the building is cropped at the top, we will apply motion blur for a better effect. In the transition setting menu, increase the motion blur value. This will give a greater sense of speed and at the same time, disguise the fact that the building is not fully visible. And that's how the effect would look. If we want, we can adjust the duration of the building's transition or move the clip to the left so that the building appears a bit earlier. These are two transitions we can easily apply to this effect, but you can also try other transitions available in DaVinci Resolve. To finish the effect, we just need to add any photo underneath to transition from one photo to another. Look for the exact frame where the black background no longer appears. Then, import a different image to place before it. Make sure to place it in the frame where the black background is no longer visible. There must be a photo underneath throughout the entire duration of the transition. And now, this transition applied to our photos is ready to be uploaded to social media. If you enjoyed this video, I have many more tutorials about DaVinci Resolve on my channel. If you're interested in learning more effects or transitions, take a look. See you in the next video.